Hello, my name is Drew Pickles, the gayest, most swell doopy faggot in the universe, and today I am going to National Sorry Day. You're probably wondering why I would go to this so-called Australian holiday. It is because all the Aussie niggers, better known as Aboriginals, will all be out in full force and demanding all the sexy white men of Australia to say sorry for atrocities committed centuries ago. This will enrage me, because no sexy man should have to apologize for something they didn't do. So in order to get to Australia, I will have to get on a plane. When I get to the airport, there will be a fucking mastodonic long line of various cunts from the racist rainbow, including, but not limited to, Mexicans, nigga baby daddies with their shitcorns of children, wiggas, dirka dirka sand niggers, ning non ping pong ting tong bin bon chin chong Asians, more fucking Mexicans, hook-nosed penny sniffing Jews, and more fucking Mexicans. I will be in the line for the space of what seems like the amount of time it would take for Australia to legalize same-sex marriage, but in reality is only 0.00013645467564 milliseconds before I get impatient and start raping all the men in the line like nobody stops Drew Pickles from getting on an airplane. Whenever I go to another country, these videos always have a part with me at an airport. Oh, fucking hell, it's too early in this video to break the fourth wall. I'm using pieces of the fourth wall and still dislike. OMG, here comes him, here comes my man juice like bag. That was swell. So after that I will finally get on the plane and skip ahead to the part where I get to Australia. When I get there will be another fucking long line, this time filled with bogan Aussie white men, Aussie niggers slash aboriginals, drunk Aussie niggers slash aboriginals, cashed up Aussie niggers slash aboriginals, even more fucking Aussie niggers slash aboriginals, white Aussies who are only 1/16th part aboriginal. Seeing this melting pot of mostly swell men will get me so horny, causing me to pull out my 300-mile-long cock and masturbate like wait, what the fuck? There's also ugly female Aussie niggers. This will enrage me so much that I stop masturbating and start smacking them to death with my 300-mile-long cock like smack 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 smack. You bitches wear the pants in most of your relationships. Smack 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 that or get domestically abused. Smack 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 smack. Here's a fucking cask of wine for you as a handbag. Smack 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 smack. Smack 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 smack. Once they are all out of the way, I will then start raping my way through the line, going from Aussie nigger to white Aussie like try claiming your Central Link benefits with a sore anus. Or maybe the disability one, since most of you won't be able to walk after this. I did so much research about you people in my plane trip here. Why should we all say sorry for shit we haven't done anyway? ? The National Sorry Day, right? More like National Rape Day. Okay, this part is taking a while, so time for my come like bag. That was well. Now that all the men have gone down, to the ground from intense fucking, the Prime Minister will step out of his office, thinking all that noise was another fucking pointless protest. He will see the freshly fucked Aussie niggers and other men in the ground, and say what the bloody hell is going on here? Why are these people in the ground like a praying Muslim? Are they about to bomb my office? I will then say hello, my name is Drew Pickles and I am just turning National Sorry Day into National Swelly Day by raping all these Aboriginal asses who want everyone to say sorry. The Prime Minister will be shocked at this confession, since a lot of these people are voters his government panders to, and he will say, oh my fucking god, you're such a sick fuck. Why the fuck would anyone do something like you think you're the first Prime Minister I've raped? You're like the 69th Prime Minister in 4 years I've raped. Seriously, this country changes Prime Ministers more frequently than changing underwear. You even had a female Prime Minister who I beat with my 300-mile cock like smack 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 smack. But I'm getting off topic once again, so anyway, once I'm done with this I will go to the nearest podcast, I'm so thirsty. Speaking of thirsty, time your ass had a drink like bag. That was well. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. This sounds like so much fucking fun down under, down under. I think I will go to Australia for National Sorry Day right now. Later, my sexy Aussie faggots.